This thing need to last. I don't know whether you're getting it.
Amen. Yes.
Revoking satanic standing order.
Yes.
Esther had everything going well. Why was he in tears? Why? Well, because this legislation was the foundation of permanent bondage. Mm-hmm. It was the foundation for permanent bondage. It was the foundation for permanent bondage. And it was better. It is revoked now. She was not just crying for her life. No. She was crying as to for several generations that have come. Amen. For her children. I pray for you.
Amen.
The blessing that God is bringing to you, amen, the money, the finances, yes, it will last.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, why was she crying? Because this oppression will be a repeated oppression. Mm. It's going to be a repeated oppression. It will be keep going. You know, the Bible used to talk about the laws of the Medes are partial, yes, that cannot be revoked. Mm. Esther understood this. Why was she crying? Because the Lord is going to be like a spiritual relapse.
Yeah.
You know, spiritual relapse? Doctor, you understand? When you say a particular sickness, relapse or fever, what do you mean? You know, it's like the thing will keep coming back. It keeps coming back. It keeps coming back, reversing back to status quo. Mm. Free? But well, your freedom is just temporary. Mm. Freedom is just temporary. You know, failure to maintain a high state. Failure to maintain what? A high state.
Yes.
That's what, you know, spiritual relapse is.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord spoke to me clearly. There are some of us here that need to deal with what you call spiritual relapse,
yes,
in our lives. Oh, you go up, but you know, you see, you keep going back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't go to a next level.
Mm-hmm.
You can't go to a next level. You cannot maintain a new level.
Yeah.
There is a spiritual relapse. Because there's a foundation calling, say, my friend, it is written, you can't go beyond this. Any power, any spirit saying you should not go beyond this level spiritually, let that power be arrested in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a written spiritual order. It's an order. It's a standing order. It's there. It's there. All it does is to bring back the people back,
yes,
to square one. Bring them back to square one. Bring them back to square one. As I say, it's not just time to jubilate. It's not time! Yes! Fine! But there's something that needs to be upturned. Where is that ability? In your life, in your family, and in this ministry. This weekend, it will be demolished.
Amen!
Let me hear a better amen.
Amen! Amen!
Why was Esther crying? Because she saw a foundation of reoccurrence. What I went through before, I'm going through it again. It's like a circle. A circle.
Yes.
Sometimes we experience a circle.
Yes.
You know, a circle. There's something that needs to be revoked.
Amen.
There's an order,
amen,
that needs to be revoked.
Amen.
Why was she crying? The king was confused. But Esther was crying. Why was she crying? Jesus. Because she saw a foundation of certain death. She saw a foundation of certain death. The Jews, all the Jews will be wiped out. Everyone will be killed. Killing, 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 killing. Things die. I prophesy to you. Nothing will die in your hand.
Amen.
Amen. Anymore.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why was she crying over six? Because she wanted to revoke the license that we did continue to despise the Jews. And today I pray for you. Any order that make it compulsory for you to be despised anywhere you go, and then you're marrying, your business, whatever.